I did not think this would ever be physically possible. Look at that! This is a new super resolution technique for videos and video games, so in goes a really coarse, pixelated piece of footage, and out comes this absolute beauty. And the input is, look, 270p. That is a really low resolution. A potato can compute that. So whenever you see LR, that is the low resolution input. Ours marks the new technique, and GT is the ground truth, that is, rendering the true result in a high resolution without any help, which, of course, takes much longer, but is necessary for comparisons. The Eastern Village scene offers some of the best super resolution results that I have ever seen. Goodness! Wow! It is really close to the ground truth, too. And so far, you have seen nothing yet. Look at the medieval dock scene here. That is some kind of joke, right? I mean, just look at the vegetation here. A bunch of pixels. Would you be able to make a drawing pixel by pixel and guess what this exactly should look like if it were in a higher resolution? For me, not a chance. But this new technique, wow! That is stunning. Yes, it still has trouble with thin structures like this. That is the 2-minute paper special, but to think that it can go from this to this sounds like something straight out of a science fiction movie. And I am really, really hoping that this can one day be the future of gaming. Could we just buy a cheapo video card, render the game at a really low resolution, let this AI do its magic, and off we go? Also, this is all well and good, but how fast or slow is it? If you take an hour to do this per image, that is not very practical, is it? So, how long does all this take? Let's have a look together. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai-Fehér. Well, for a previous method from just 3 years ago, took more than 100 milliseconds per frame, which is 10 frames per second just for super resolution. And we haven't even rendered the game, so that is clearly not practical. In fact, it wouldn't fit easily on this chart because the bars would be so long. Wow, that is almost 10x faster than the technique from 3 years ago, that is stunning. But there are other techniques out there, so what about those? Well, if you are looking for a mild 2x, doubling the resolution, the new one blows the doors off. It can do this 82 times per second, easily twice, almost 3 times as fast as some of its competitors from last year. Super good! Now, let's bump it up to 3x. Oh yes, things are getting closer now, but it still comes out ahead. And if we are really demanding, we want to quadruple the input resolution, it takes a tiny bit longer than Fuse SR, a fantastic technique from just a year ago. So, in that case, I wonder if it is worth waiting this much for. Let's have a look together. Yes, the new one is certainly better here and is worth the longer execution time, while other cases are a bit more subjective. Which one do you feel is better? Let me know in the comments below. And now, let's try to resolve this somehow together. So far, we eyeballed the results. Now, let's look at the numbers. Meaning, let's put a ton of these cases together and calculate a score mathematically. What does mathematics think about subjective cases like this? Who wins? Well, did we get an answer? Yes and no. But mostly yes. Let me try to explain. If we just measure the distance between the pixels compared to the true image, the new technique is clearly better. However, this metric does not understand the image, it just measures distances. If you take an image and you darken it a bit or brighten it up, it does not know that it is the same image. Thus, it gives it a poor score. So, they also checked structural similarity, that is a bit smarter as it can take into consideration that a darker version of the image is still the same image. If we look at the overall scores, the new technique does not win everywhere all the time, but it wins most of the cases. I am comfortable handing it the win. Also, technically, this new technique is chef's kiss. Why? Well, get this, it uses the Fourier transform, a mathematical technique for breaking down a signal, for instance, a song, like taking the bass guitar out of a song. And it mixes that with deep neural networks, and hence, this is called deep Fourier-based super resolution. Okay, so what are the limitations? Is it perfect? Clearly not. Thin structures are not great. There are also cases which are highly subjective. This one is a very typical case of over-sharpening versus over-blurring. Pick your poison. Temporal splotches are also present, I believe a bit less than for the previous technique from a year ago, but it's still there. That is what we are looking for to make this more practical. And finally, a disadvantage that is relatively easy to isolate. That is, fog and particle systems. In those cases, you flat out cannot use this super resolution. Not because it theoretically can't, but because it looks at geometric data from something called the G-buffer, and there is no data for particle systems in there. That is a bit of a bummer, as those can get really costly to simulate, but it is theoretically possible to pull it off. So, you know, just imagine what we will be capable of 2 more papers down the line. That is the first law of papers. For instance, I can imagine that we won't even need the high-resolution assets like geometry or textures for a game that we are creating, because we will be able to use super resolution so reliably that we simply won't need them anymore. Perhaps this will be like compression, but taken to the extreme. What a time to be alive! And to think that we have amazing papers like this appearing day by day, and scientists giving the description of the technique away for all of us for free. A fantastic scientific contribution and a great gift to humanity. Thank you. So, what do you fellow scholars think? Let me know in the comments below. We need new tools for the era of LLMs, and Weights and Biases now has Weave, a lightweight toolkit to confidently iterate on LLM applications. Use traces to debug how data flows through each step of your app, and use evaluations to measure your progress. It is the best! Try it out now at wnb.me/papersllm or click the link in the description below.